So if you talk about any vertical segment, top 10 verticals out of top 10 verticals, top take auto, take textile, take retail, take chemicals, out of top 10, five or six companies must be running SAP. So that's the kind of credential and that's the kind of market attraction which SAP has procured in last couple of years in India. Seven out of 13 Indian firms named by Businessweek, Asia's hot growth companies, list runs SAP. If we talk about the market share, SAP still is a market leader with 55% of the market share when in ERP space as well as in ERP new dimension products like CRM, like SRM, supply chain, and the product lifecycle management. If we talk about the differential in the second competitor, it's Oracle, and their market share is only 8%. So it's a monopoly, you can say that, which SAP is having in the ERP application space. Not only in mid-enterprise but large enterprise as well. The smallest customer of SAP is for 10 crores and the largest customer which we are having is a 50,000 crore company which is using SAP. So that is the kind of magnitude in which SAP runs through. Now this is a, I think this slide is a very representative slide. It basically covers the 50,000 tower level field view of SAP, how SAP looks like. So to start with, SAP is basically not only strong in application and functional space, it's very strong in technical space as well. It is based upon the NetWeaver based technology, that is ABAP. The objective of this NetWeaver is basically helps in SAP in communicating with the third party application, whether it's a process or whether it's a third party application, whether it's a Wayne Bridge or a barcode reader. So the smallest of the application can also be integrated and the largest of the application and the most complex application like PLC machines can also be integrated with SAP through this application. The second layer you can see over there is for corporate services. So that includes my travel management, like all the travel related, including the ticketing, including your reimbursement, including the date and schedule of the flights and other things. It also covers the environmental health and safety. So this is basically an upcoming thing and government is basically getting it operated and executed in most part of the business in India for mid-enterprise, like people need to have an environmental health and safety modes which are available. Now incentive and commission for all the sales guys. Sorry. The corporate real estate, that basically covers whatever the real estate companies or not only for real estate companies, whatever the projects which are coming, commissioning of plant or acquisition of land for the projects commissioning. So that all covers the in SAP. If you talk about operations, all the operations including procure to pay, like material management including inventory, your production planning, project management, your plant maintenance, the quality management from the procurement and from the production and from the sales goods side. A distribution and sales order management also covers in that. So the extension of this, it also can be handled through the CRM, which can directly cater and the customer is also the part of the SAP family or the customer family. So dealer also can be accessible within SAP. So we can also provide with the dealer portal. Now fourth part is the human capital management. For any of the companies in India, the important workforce is basically their workforce who are working for them. So to manage and to provide them with 100% benefit, SAP also provides a solution for that. So that covers in human capital management, which also includes the Indian payroll. So that is very, Indian payroll is also the addition of this. It covers all the levies and common rules and regulations in the product itself. After that, 6 over 8 is financials. Financials is basically the heart of any organization. So the SAP is a hardcore integrated solution. So there is no entry in finance. In fact, there are a lot of entries which are coming. There are a lot of entries which are coming into finance. So the finance is basically for the reporting or some of the accounting or for the general voucher if you want to prepare the vouchers. So it's a beautiful system in terms of integration, in terms of scalability of the whole stuff. And the last but not the least, SAP is considered to be the best analytical software which is available in the market with the huge transactional data available for that. So the definition of the SAP is basically it's very integrated and at a very strong transactional level system. But at the same point of time, you will get thousands of important reports for the decision maker to get it defined and at the right point of time. So there are a lot of business analytical reports which are strategic, enterprise management, your financial analytics, workflows analytics, your operation analytics. So the important objective here is that it's not a person dependent report, it's a system dependent report. At any point of time, the managing director or a director of the company can get into the voucher level to find out where is the difference, where is the issue. To resolve that particular issue, he does not need to depend upon the employee of an organization. So the whole situation of the system will basically changes because it is a system dependent, not a person dependent. Now based on businesses around SAP, so there are huge list of customers you will find out here in each and every vertical segment, including discrete, process, service industry, consumer and retail, and SME in mid-market. So we'll find whole list of customers over there, including your automotive leaders like Mahindra, Zero and others of the world, to the Indian Oil and NTPCs of this. We'll also have all the IT companies like Wipro, Infosys are also run SAP for their internal operations. So you can find out that how much critical of them for using SAP in terms of their project management. The thousands of projects which Infosys basically offer to their customers is being supported by SAP internally. I talked earlier about that SAP caters to 28 different verticals. So these are the examples of it, including the Reliance Utility, Reliance Retail, Reliance Life Sciences, Chemical, Oil and Gas, Petro, Consumer Nicholas, Pharma, their Pharma Division, Glass Division and Textile Division. Reliance again, Power, Telecom, Textile, Insurance and Mutual Fund. So huge list of vertical segments. You talk about any segment, we are there. Not only there, we have a very strong roots basically available for that. Now why SAP has an advantage or why SAP has emerged as the strongest application current in the world is basically, we basically run for each and every project. If you talk about, we have a customer list of almost around 65,000 companies, and out of that 2,000 plus customers are in life sciences space. I'm just giving life sciences space as an example. So in last 12 years, we have gathered about these list of customers in life sciences. With each and every project, whatever the best practices which we have developed and incorporated over there, we incorporated in the standard product. So if you talk about any of the process which is getting streamlined in any of a company, so there are hundreds of options in fact for that particular process to be getting streamlined there. So that is basically the advantage. It's not like any other ERP where people will come and ask about that, how you want to have this process, and they incorporate and implement it. In SAP, you will find out the list of options that how that particular process can be streamlined and incorporated in the system. And then you can choose and define about with the experience of the implementation partner in the product and with the vast experience behind the product of having implemented in number of same sites. So that best practices, that number of options in the product can also be helpful for the future list of customers. So that can save time. So there are a lot of advantages like tangible and intangible benefits which are available after using SAP. So that is why. And for the information, in my first slide, I said that almost 7,000 crore per year is invested upon the product development for SAP. That is one of the major reasons why the product is basically coming concrete.